Het Academisch Ziekenhuis Paramaribo, het Sint Vincentius Ziekenhuis en het Slanshospitaal mochten gisteren elk een ambulance in ontvangst nemen van de in Suriname opererende Maleisische oliemaatschappij Petronas. De vertegenwoordigers van de ziekenhuizen tonen zich elk dan ook verheugd met de gesten. Manoj Hindori, directeur van Sint Vincentius Ziekenhuis, greep het moment aan om aan te geven dat het een goede gelegenheid is om te starten met een Nationaal Ambulance Service Center. Nu is het juiste moment om het plan zo snel als mogelijk op te zetten, opdat de ziekenhuizen samen krachtig kunnen optrekken. Evenals de vertegenwoordigers van het AZP en Sint Vincentius Ziekenhuis, zegt de medisch directeur van het Slanshospitaal, Sunita Nanandpandey, dat een ambulance onmisbaar is voor een ziekenhuis. En toch heeft het Slanshospitaal het eens zonder een ambulance moeten doen, zegt de medisch directeur.
We had to function for a very long time without one. Due to all kinds of technical problems and costly maintenance prices, the ambulances we had to be parked in the garage, really. There were no financial means to buy a new one ourselves, and other choices of priority had to be made. And now, when we find ourselves in the middle of all kinds of crises, especially an economic one, it has only become a far-fetched dream to purchase such a necessary asset like an ambulance on our own. It has already been said by my colleague. In the period when we couldn't use our own defect ambulances, we had to look for other solutions for transportation of our patients, especially for our most smallest ones, our newborns, mostly premature, who needed to be transported as fast as possible to the NICU here in the academic hospital. Luckily, we found help with our sister hospitals, the academic hospital, the St. Vincentius Hospital, and most of all, the military hospital. Recently, also a very close friend of our hospital was so generous enough to surprise us with one of his own. But you can imagine that is not an ideal situation, one working ambulance and two in the garage. So when Mr. Gordon Vogt approached us with the news that there was a donor for three ambulances, and one of them was for our hospital, we were very happy in the knowledge that soon at least one of the crises, the ambulance crisis, would be over.
Met de drie ambulances heeft Petronas ruim $100,000 gedoneerd aan de gezondheidszorg. Country manager Khairul Hamid Khalid zegt dat het met de eerste donatie is aan het Academisch Ziekenhuis. Dat het niet de eerste donatie is aan het Academisch Ziekenhuis Paramaribo.
This is not our first contribution to AZP. We've been very happy to work with them for the last couple of years. And you know, a couple of months ago I had the opportunity to attend an event of launching similar to this with Mr. Brahim. And I was very touched to know that what we contributed in the NICU has in fact saved a lot of lives. Lives that would have been lost without our contribution. And that has a very, very deep emotional tie to me, because you know that money in terms of Petronas is very small, but the effect it brings to the community, it's limitless. And I'm very proud to say that with this contribution of ambulances to St. Vincentius, AZP, and also Slans, can have that effect. You know, ambulances are very important. Road condition in Suriname is not that is good, but you need good transportation to bring people to hospitals. And like I said, Petronas will still continue to operate in Suriname. And as long as we continue to be in Suriname, we will continue to support efforts to bring well-being to the community. And what we have chosen to be in our CSR project is to give a specific emphasis on the health community in Suriname.
Petronas is de nationale oliemaatschappij in Maleisië en heeft in nog 30 andere landen operaties lopen. In Suriname hebben zij drie offshore concessies die zij opereren onder contract met Staatsoliemaatschappij Suriname. Petronas zegt ze zullen blijven doneren aan de Surinaamse gezondheidszorg.